In this example, I'd like to review the solution of a very simple problem. We take a bar, restrain it on the left side, and we apply a force F onto the right-hand side. So the length of the bar is going to be L, and we'll let the cross-sectional area and the Young's modulus be constants. And we're going to try and find U of x, so the deformation of the bar, and R of x, the internal force in the bar. So this is a problem can be approached in many ways, but we'll look at it using the second order ODE that governs the equilibrium of the bar in terms of the displacement. So AE equals U double prime plus B equals zero. So B is the distributed axial force that's applied to the bar, and the primes denote differentiation with respect to axial coordinate x. Okay, so in this problem, B of x is zero. There are no loads applied in the bar itself. There's only a restraint on the left side and a force on the right side. And we need boundary conditions. And so we have U of zero equals zero, and we have that R at L is equal to F. And it's convenient to re-express the force in terms of the motion, so we can write that as AE U prime of L, so that equals F. So my boundary conditions I'll be using are that guy there and this guy there. So from here on out, it's relatively straightforward. So we'll start with the equation, AE U double prime equals zero. We'll integrate both sides once. AE U prime equals some constant of integration. And notice that this is actually equal to R of x here. That'll make it convenient to apply one of the boundary conditions. And then we can integrate one more time. AE U is equal to C1x plus C2. And so C1 and C2 are the constants of integration. If I evaluate U of 0, I find AE, I find that 1 over AE times C1 times 0 plus C2 must equal 0. So that immediately tells me that C2 equals 0. And then I have my other boundary condition, AEU prime of L equals F. So that tells me that AEU prime of L equals F equals C1. So I found out that C1 equals F. So my final solution then is U of x is equal to 1 over AE times F times x. And we're also asked to find what the internal force R of x is. And R of x is up here. It's equal to AE U prime, which equals C1. So I have R of x is equal to F. And if we think about that, that makes complete sense. If I make a section cut in the bar anywhere up over here, could be there or there, I'll always be looking at picture that looks as follows, F R of x. So that picture immediately tells me that R of x is always equal to F. So that matches this relationship that I have here. And this relationship here tells me that if I make a plot, U of x versus x, then I have a linear distribution. And then the terminal value here for the displacement is F L over AE, which is the typical standard solution that you find in most textbooks for this problem.